Hey, fellow beauty finders, this is Matthias Allen. Now, for those of you who are not aware of who I am a working makeup artist here in Los Angeles. And if you're brand new to my channel, I would love for you guys to subscribe. So if you enjoy this video you're about to watch, click the thumbs up tab and leave me a comment down below. Now, I do weekly video demos, makeup hauls, product reviews, and sit-down interviews with fellow professional artists. So Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, I have a brand new video, and I would love, love, love for you guys to come back every single week to hear what's new in beauty and what I got up my sleeve. So what you're about to see is a series of quick tips. Now, I worked with my good friend and client Hortensia, and I'm going to show you some specific professional tips and tricks for how to get some amazing, easy to accomplish eyes, cheeks, lips, and everything else in between. So stay tuned for those coming right up. So people are always asking me, what should I set my makeup with? I'm using pressed powder, or I'm using powder foundation, or is it loose powder that I'm supposed to use? Am I supposed to use a puff, or am I supposed to use a brush? Well, there's lots of different ways to set your makeup, but technically, I don't recommend using pressed powder or powder foundation to set your makeup, because when your makeup is dewy from the foundation and the concealer, right, you don't want to take pressed powder and swirl your brush into it, because pressed powder is very similar to loose powder. The difference is that oil has been added to keep the product together. The only way that loose powder will sit in a compact and stay together is by adding oil and then pressing it together. So when you take a brush and you swirl into pressed powder or powder foundation, you're getting the oil mixed into your powder brush. So that's not going to give you a very long-lasting matte finish. I recommend loose powder. Loose powder comes in a variety of shades, colors, different brands make them. I'm going to show you the Cargo HD Picture Perfect Translucent Powder today, and I'm going to show you how much I love it. So the Cargo HD Loose Powder is very, very, very fine. As you can see, it floats. I don't know if you can see that in the camera, but it actually floats away from the skin. It has silica in it, which is fantastic for diminishing pores. It gives a very natural matte finish. And I'm using one of my favorite brushes from IT Cosmetics. IT Cosmetics is a fantastic brand, and the owner has come up with these amazing brushes which feel flawless on the skin. I mean, you really feel like you're being patted down by like a little baby, right? A little baby's hands, right? It's so soft and gentle. And this powder is just perfect. One of my favorite. So anyway, so loose powder is definitely the way to set your makeup, because it's gonna go on much finer, much more translucent. It's gonna make your makeup last all day long. I've seen too many people that have set their makeup with pressed powder, and that's when you get a cake face, because you're mixing that pressed powder and the oil together with your foundation, and that's just not a good combo. So I hope you guys enjoyed that Quick Tips Pro Artist demo. As always, I'd love to hear your thoughts, so please leave me a comment down below and click the thumbs up tab if you enjoyed this video. Follow me on all social media at Matthias for Makeup. I'm also doing live Periscope feeds every other day, so follow me on the new Periscope app. And if you guys want to see how I work with Hortensia's hooded eyes to make them look larger and brighter, click right here on this video. And if you want to see how I created that flawless complexion in part two of this series with her, then click right here. And for those of you that are new to my channel, I would love it if you subscribed, because I do 3 weekly demos. So please, please, please hit the subscribe button before you go. And remember to find the beauty within. Thanks for watching.